Hello and welcome, my friend. Next, I am planning to show you that how to clean this piston. I have in here this piston, that how I can clean these pistons, this oil rings, those oil holes. And there is really holes in inside when we look that piston area. There is really situation that there are pistons in there are holes in behind this piston ring. And next I am planning to show you that how we can clean and make those holes what are inner in this piston area again in this good condition, and how we can fix and repair that thing. Okay, and then when we look that piston what is in my hand, there are now situation that I have take this piston away in this my engine, and now this engine is like in upside down, and these pistons belongs in here in this position. And in that hole, what is in here when I rotate in that crankshaft area, I have took that piston away. And this piston is from this Toyota's this 1.8 and 1.6 liter gasoline engines, this piston. And then we go to look that piston closer, that what this holes look like. And let's go to look that. Okay, and here we have then this my piston. And first step is that I need to take these piston rings away, and it happens so that I start in this first upper ring, and first I look that where is this hole, and there is this hole in that area. And then I only little bit I bend that carefully in that position, and then in that way, if we are planning to use this old piston rings, we take that in this way away. And then I have next this compression ring in here, and I little bit make this wider. And in that way, I can carefully take this away in this upper hole. Because if we bend these rings too much, then they can go broken. Now I move that in here. And then I notice that I need a little bit move that. I can take that away. And now it went away, the second compression ring. And then we have this final thing, this oil ring. And now I can right away see when I have this flathead screwdriver that normally this oil ring must move and rotate. And I move that in this way. But now this my oil ring is totally stuck because I have, and my previous car owners, they have used poor quality motor oil and too long this oil replace periods, and that's this ring is stuck. And now when I look, there is very small hole in there where I can open this this oil ring in that way. Now I manage to open it, and then I rotate that, and there is this piston. And when we look that oil ring, we can see that it must be normally totally clean. And in that area, inner area, it is full of black, this dusty, sticky corrosion, unlike burnt oil, because my engine oil it has been too long time inside in my engine, and that's oil became like coil, and it is like dusty, sticky situation. When we compare in that compression ring, what is still quite okay, I a little bit polish that, it is okay, but this oil ring is too dusty, and if I try to polish that, there is this black particles in there, and this is like very hard and rough thing. Okay, and then I take this final this oil ring away, and now I am searching this cut point. Where is this small hole? There I can see in that position, in there is small cut hole in there. And then when I insert my tool in there, I can easily take that now this ring out in this up down area in that way. This is also possible, that in that way I can take this upper oil ring away. And then there is this final, now when I took away, now this oil ring moves a little bit, and this is normal situation. This oil ring must move in that way, and if it not, then we have stuck oil ring. And then I little bit carefully I take that in this way bigger, and there is this oil rings, this central part, and it looks like that. And then we can look this piston oil ring holes, that where are they, and they are in their inner. When we look in that area, there we can see in that point there is 1, 2, but they are stuck. There is no any movement. And then when we look in here inner area, we can see in their holes, one hole, second and third hole in their inner area. But when we look in that area, we can't see anything. And now I take a little bit more light, that we can see those things. That there are those oily, there has been those holes when this engine was new. But now those holes are away, and in that way, when we have more light, and I take sharp tool, that kind of small hook, I can show that in, when I little bit move that in that position in here, directly in that position, there is one hole, but I am now pressing, and now I am trying to do hole in there. And now it interesting that when I insert light in their inner, we can't see in anything in here, because those holes are stuck. And there are now in that side, where is this connection rod, 1, 2, 3 holes in here. And then I need to only take this dirties and this bad oil away, because these holes must be open always, because oil goes through these holes, and if they are stuck, then this piston's oil ring, this oil movement is stop and it don't work, and it is bad situation. And now I can try to do these holes using this my sharp this head, or then I can use very small screw, this drill, and I can do those holes through. But now I try to use this my sharp, this head, that I can show that there is really those holes, and I work a little bit with those things, and I can actually insert in then here this VD40, what should make those. Now we can maybe see better those holes in here, when we there is possibility to see those when we go forward. Now we can maybe see in here, this is first, and then second is in here, and third is in here, and all of those, they are stuck. But quite soon, when I work a little bit, we have hole in there, and it is actually 1 millimeter hole. And I work a little bit, and soon we can see, we can use any tool that we can do this hole through. One possibility is use to this this metallic wire. There is this, and I try to insert that in, and it takes a little bit time when I move, because there is this many years now when I let's look that when I can take this, make this hole, and then I think that I can use also very small drill. There I have this package full of these drills, and then I try to find what is the most smallest. There is very small this drill bite, and this size is only 1 millimeter. Size is only 1 millimeter. It is really small. And then when I insert that in here, and then I rotate that, soon there should be hole. And now I think that I can use my screwdriver. There is this my small drill bite. This in here, and then I take this my electric drill, and now when this is small, so small drill bite, I can insert that my drill bite in here that way. This is so small that can I even insert that in here? Okay, no, this is too small. And that's I need next my Dremel tool. Okay, and now I notice that when I have this small 1 millimeter this drill bite, I managed to do so that when I have tongs in here, and when I little bit move that, I can take this my drill bite away, and this is so small drill bite that my Dremel don't work with that. But then I noticed that when I insert that my drill bite in this hole, what is in there, this hole, what is stuck, and then I take my hammer, and I carefully hammer that, and then it goes through. Cool. And then we can look in their inner area also. And there we can see that there is this my drill bite in their inner, that area. And it is good. And there is my drill bite. Now when I need to take that my drill bite out, I take only my tongs and I carefully lift drill bit out. And now there is this free hole in there. There is first three hole, and for that purpose, when I take this my drill bit in my tongs, and I a little bit move that in more times. Now I have made two holes, and one is still stuck. And now, by the way, my drill bit goes broken. This is so weak, but I think that I like to still open this last stuck hole. And there is then this my hammer. Good. And now it is there. And again I take it out. And now it is a little bit stuck, but now it is free. And then we can do this test, that are these my holes in their inner area. In there we can see that there is three of those holes, and then I insert my piston in that position, and then this light in their inner, we should then see in their inner area. And I believe that now we can see through those holes that we can see that there is light in there when we look that area. Yes, and now I have those holes free, and then I need to also open this another sides, those three holes. And then this my piston oil ring holes service is ready, and then I can install this piston back to my engine. That kind of interesting information.